Okay, in this video, I want to talk a little bit more about the constellation Orion, which we've discussed a couple times. It's come up a few times. I'll give a few interesting details about it now. And also be aware that we've got a little answer for you here in terms of question number 46. And what 46 says is, we know the North Star points us north. Is there an east-west beacon in the sky? And what about a South Star? So we know most of that question. We know the North Star points us north, and we know there's no South Star. We've discussed that. But we will discuss now, is there an east-west beacon in the sky? And here we go. It's with Orion. So first of all, Orion, this is the constellation art that I sort of took out of Stellarium, the solar system simulator, and you see all the usual things here. Betelgeuse is a reddish star right at the hunter's armpit there. There's three very distinctive stars which form his belt. The one on the very end there has a name called Mintaka. And Mintaka is going to be the star we need to focus our attention on in these slides to get that question number 46 answered. We're not too worried about the names of the other two. And of course, Rigel here is a bluish star that's in the foot of Orion. And I have the animal, well, here's the animal that he's sort of beating with his club here. The club's over here and so on. So, but the most distinguishing features of this constellation are Betelgeuse reddish, the very distinctive belt, and the bluish Rigel down there in the foot. And remember the name Mintaka as being that top star on the belt. Okay. Here's sort of an overexposed actual photograph of what you might see in the night sky. And you see all the usual things that I just tried to tell you about. Betelgeuse right there, the big red one. There's the very distinctive belt. And there's Rigel right there on his foot. And those are about the only ones I ever remember of Orion. So off we go then. It turns out that Orion in the sky has a very interesting position. And the star that's being discussed right here, that is Mintaka. Mintaka right there. And what's so interesting about Mintaka is when Mintaka goes to set like that, it will set due west. And put an exclamation point around that. It'll set exactly in the west. Every day, no matter what, it'll set in the west. It's not like the sun that wanders all over the celestial sphere. It always has this westward setting. And what that tells you then on Mintaka is that Mintaka is on the celestial equator. Put an exclamation point after that too, and maybe even a happy face next to it. That's pretty cool. That means that the declination is equal to 0 degrees of it, because it's on the celestial equator, which means it's over our equator. Remember how the two things are sort of oriented here. Here's our Earth like that. And if you want to go draw the celestial sphere around our Earth, it's going to sort of look like that with the matching poles. Remember, that's the big blanket in the sky that surrounds the Earth according to this model. And it turns out that that dot right there, that's Mintaka. It's right there on the celestial equator. So yeah, there's other stars in the belt and in the constellation of Orion, but Mintaka happens to fall right on the equator. So watch this animation now. So let me just get this animation going and just note that we have the direction due east. And so here we go. Animation's running. Don't worry about all this stuff. I didn't mean to get it on there. Here we go. And this is Mintaka right here. This is the one we want to focus our attention on right here. So Orion is rising in the sky. Remember, keep an eye on this star right here. That's Mintaka. So it sort of goes and turns in the sky as it reaches its highest point and comes down. And here we go. Wait for it now. Again, here's Mintaka right here. So it's setting. It's getting lower and lower and lower. Here comes the ground. Here comes the ground. Here comes the ground. There's Mintaka right there. Right there. And blammo. Look at that, how Mintaka just went right through that W. Went right through the W. So what we saw then is Mintaka, that star of Orion here, it rises due east and sets due west because it's on the celestial equator. And that's just pretty cool. So see, it almost like there is an east-west star. Now, it's not always up there. You can't always look to the east and find it like you can with a North Star. But if you can get your eyes on the constellation of Orion and watch it move over the course of a night, or the morning even, you can watch it rise, Mintaka, due east and set due west to help give you some of your bearing perspective on your bearing. Lastly then, let me just flip back just for a second here. And if I can get rid of some of these things, like I want to just look quickly at Betelgeuse, okay? That's that big orange star in the armpit of Orion. It's very easy to recognize in the night sky.